So today's lecture is related to anti-lock braking system. What is anti-lock braking system? Anti-lock braking system is an automobile safety system. It prevents the wheels of a vehicle locking as brake pedal pressure is applied. Often suddenly, in an emergency or short stopping distance, this enables the driver to have steering control, preventing skidding and lost traction. So this is actually the controlling of the vehicle. Okay, if we apply the brakes, then vehicle may not skid or may not roll over. This type of problems may be avoided by using this system, that is anti-lock braking system. If we see the history, 1929, anti-lock braking system was first developed for aircraft by the French automobile and aircraft pioneer Gabriel Voisin. Okay, who is the inventor of this system? As threshold braking on airplane is nearly impossible, 1936, German company Bosch is awarded a patent and apparatus for preventing lock braking of wheels in a motor vehicle. In 1936 also, Bosch and Mercedes work on this. And then after that, 1972, WABCO partner Mercedes-Benz developing first ABS for trucks. In 1978, also first production line installation of ABS into Mercedes and BMW vehicles. 1981, 1 lakh Bosch ABS installed, and 1985, first ABS installed on US vehicles. This is continued. Nowadays, almost all new cars have ABS. Okay, for development of this system, under hard braking, an ideal braking system should provide the shortest stopping distance on all surfaces and maintain the vehicle stability and steer ability. Okay, so if we see here, if we apply the brakes or braking point is available. Okay, so the with ABS system and without ABS system, if we use ABS system, then vehicle may stop short distance, but if we if we apply the brake after that, also vehicle gets moved and it damage or it touches the side objects. So see here, the object which is available at the roadside or near to roadside, when we apply the brakes, then that gets touches to that object. Okay, and some accident may happens. So but if we apply the anti-lock braking system, then it safely stops the vehicle or control the vehicles and skidding is stopped. Many different control methods for ABS system have been developed. These methods differ in their theoretical basis and performance under the changes of road conditions. ABS research, if we see, then classical control is there, optical control is there, non-linear control, robust control, adaptive control, intelligent control. These are the different systems which are available in this ABS control. When the brake pedal is depressed during driving, the wheel speed decreases. Okay, when we, brake pedal is depressed during driving, the wheel speed decreases and the vehicle speed does as well. Okay, the decrease in the vehicle speed, however, is not always proportional to the decrease in the wheel speed. The non-correspondence between the wheel speed and vehicle speed is called slip. Okay, and the magnitude of the slip is expressed by the slip ratio, which is defined as follows. Slip ratio is equal to vehicle speed minus wheel speed divided by vehicle speed into 100%. When the slip ratio is 0%, the vehicle speed corresponds exactly to wheel speed. When it is 100%, the wheels are completely locking, that is rotating at zero speed while the vehicle is moving. This is the relation between braking coefficient and wheel slip. If we see on the x-axis, wheel slip is available. Okay, and if we observe this graph, then this is the ABS release zone. Okay, if we observe here, this is the ABS zones. So this red color lines indicates the boundaries. So first red color line, dotted line, on the left side of that red color line, that region is called as no ABS action. Okay, when the region is ABS hold zone, okay, this is the ABS hold zone and this is the ABS release zone. These are the three different categories here we provided. The base breaking action occurs at between 10% to 20%. Okay, so in between 10 to 20%, the base breaking action takes place. If vehicle speed in speed and wheel speed is the same, wheel slippage is 0%. Vehicle speed and wheel speed is same, then if we minus that, because in this formula, this is the vehicle speed minus wheel speed. So zero. So if we consider the vehicle speed is 10 meter per second and wheel speed is also 10 meter per second. So 10 minus 10, this becomes zero. And zero into 100, that is slip ratio is zero. In this situation, if vehicle speed and wheel speed is the same, wheel slippage is 0%. A lockup wheel will have a wheel slippage of 100%. When the wheel gets locked up, then the situation is like 100% slippage takes place. Principles of ABS operations, if we observe here, it shows the relation between braking coefficient and wheel slip. It is shown that the slide values for stopping or traction force are proportionately higher than the slide values for cornering steering force. A lockup wheel provides low road handling force and minimal steering force. If we see the principle, the main benefit from anti-lock braking system operation is to maintain the directional control of the vehicle during heavy braking in rare circumstances. If we see the components, then here the wheel sensors are provided. These are the wheel sensors. Then control module is provided. Modulator unit is available. Okay, then wheel sensors here also wheel sensors are provided. And in that gear pulsar is also available. Then brake disc is available. Okay, so these are the components which are related to ABS. So here also some name of the components are given. The ABS control module and hydraulic control unit. Second number is two-way connector, diagnostics connector, ABS warning light, data link connector, then transmission control module, tone wheels, ABS wheel speed sensor, wheel cylinder, G sensor, stop light switch, master cylinder, brake and ABD warning light, lateral G sensor, etc. are provided here. So ABS braking system are integrated. An integrated system has the master cylinder and control wall assembly made together. Non-integrated in this type, a non-integrator has the master cylinder and control wall assembly made a separate. If we see the ABS controller, actually in this system, four different primary components are there. First is ABS controller, the brains of the system. Okay, this ABS controller is called as the brain of the system, because ABS controller are a computer that reads the input and then controls the system to keep the wheels for locking up and skidding. It is actually related to computer, or like act as a computer. Second, ABS speed sensor. There are generally one on each wheel. Sometimes they are located on differentials. It detects a change in acceleration in the longitudinal direction of the vehicle and output it to the ABSCM as a voltage signal. Third type of is ABS modulator or wall. Some systems have separate walls for each wheel with a modulator to control them. Other systems, they are combined. In either case, they work with the controller and the pump to add or release the pressure from the individual wheels, brakes to control the braking. Fourth point is ABS pumps. Since the ABS modulator walls can release the pressure from the individual wheels, brakes, there needs to be a way to restore the pressure when required. That is what the ABS pump's job is. When the pump is cycling, the driver may experience a slight pedal vibration. This cycling is happening many times as per second, and this slight vibration is natural. These are some applications. How does it work? This is operating diagram. So the solenoid is available. Then the prime wall is available here. This is the solenoid. Then this is the PWN current driver. Then pump assembly is there. Okay, then damper is provided. And here also ISO wall is provided. This is solenoid. Apply wall, LSP, solenoid. Okay, this is the wheel. This is the release wall and solenoid. So this is the wheel. Then it is the wheel speed sensor is available here. Signal wire. If we see this diagram, in this case, cable is attached to emergency disc, that is brake lever. And in this case, the drum are available, brake sensors are available in this situation. So this is actually the operating diagram. Sensor at each of the four wheels is available, and it senses the rotation of the wheel. Too much brake application, if too much brake application takes place, then wheel stop rotating. Then sensors gives two signals to ECU, and it releases the brake line pressure. So when turns again, wheel turns again. So when we release the brake line pressure, then wheel gets turned. Then ECU applies the pressure again, stops the rotation of the wheel, releases it again, and so on. So this is about the simple, that is working. I repeat this again. Sensors are available at the each wheel. It senses the rotation of the wheel. If we apply the brake too much, then wheel gets stopped. But sensor senses that, and it gives the signal to ECU. ECU is attached to the brake line pressure. Then brake line pressure releases after the ordering from the ECU. Then wheel gets turns again. Okay. The ECU applies the pressure again, stops the rotation of the wheel, release it again, and so on. So this releasing and reapplication or pulsing of brake pressure happens 20 to 30 times per second or more. This keeps the wheel just at the limit before locking up and skidding no matter. A base system can maintain extremely high static pressure and must be disabled before attempting repairs. So here, solenoid valve assembly is also available. It's a pair of valves that can increase the pressure, hold the pressure steady, decrease the pressure. So when the pressure gets increases, the pressure increases here, and during the pressure increase, mode of operating fluid is allowed to flow through both solenoids to break the caliper. Okay, so it is allowed to flow this fluid from both the solenoids to break the caliper. And in this way, this is the solenoid second, and pressure gets decreased, that is vent solenoid, brake line under pressure. And brake fluid line not under pressure. See, dotted line is not under pressure, but this continuous line is related to under pressure. Hold pressure steady. During the pressure hold mode of operation, both solenoids are closed and no additional fluid is allowed to flow to the brake calipers. Okay, so here dotted line indicates that brake fluid line not under the pressure. And this continuous line is under the pressure. So cutoff takes place in both the solenoids. So this is the second, and third is decrease pressure. So during the pressure vent mode, the pressure increases, solenoid is closed. The vent solenoid opens, allowing fluid to vent into an accumulator chamber. Okay, so this is the vent solenoid opens. Okay, here vent solenoid is available, and that gets open into accumulator chamber. We see the system diagram. This is the diagram. So brake application or ABS enabled vehicles. So brake application is there. Then wheel speed sensors. It senses. Then it gives to ECU unit. ECU unit gives the activation or signals to modulation valves. And modulation valves adjust according to the instructions of ECU, and hydraulic pressure gets released or it gets closed, and according to the requirement. Okay, and it applies to the brakes. So this is about the general diagram. So ABS brakes are either one channel, three channel, or four channel brakes. One channel or one sensor ABS. This system is commonly found on pickup trucks with rear wheels ABS. It has one valve which controls both rear wheels and one speed sensors located in the rear axle. So three channel or three sensor ABS. This scheme commonly found on pickup trucks with four wheel ABS has a speed sensor and a valve for each of the front wheels, with one valve and one sensor for both rear wheels. The speed sensor for the rear wheel is located in the rear axle. And if we see the four channel four sensor ABS, this is the best scheme. There is a speed sensor on all four wheels and a separate valve for all four wheels. With this setup, the controller monitor each case, each wheel individually to make sure it is achieving maximum braking force. If we see the configuration options, this is one channel, three channel, and four channels. Okay, this is four channel ABS, three channel ABS, and one channel ABS. This is available on the rear wheels. See here on four wheels, all these lines are connected. This is three lines are connected. This one line is connected. These are the different configurations. So depending on the application, there are several typical layouts. So rear axle only, then individual rear wheels only, then front and rear axle control, individual front wheel, rear axle control, then individual four wheel control. These are the different conditions. Okay, so some challenges are also there. ABS control is highly non-linear control problem due to the complicated relation between its component and its parameter. The research that has been carried out in ABS control system covers a broad range of issues and challenges. Many different control methods for ABS have developed, and research on improved control methods in continuing. Okay, some research is already done here. Fuzzy control is an intelligent control system. Can we use in ABS control to emulate the qualitative aspects of human knowledge with several advantages such as robustness, universal approximation theorem, and rule-based algorithm? These are the use in this fuzzy control. Advantages, if we see, many advantages are there. It allows the driver to maintain the directional stability and control over steering during the braking. Second important advantage is safe and effectiveness. Then third is automatically changes the brake fluid pressure at each wheel to maintain optimum brake performance. Fourth is ABS absorbs the unwanted turbulence, shock waves, and modulate the pulses, thus permitting the wheel to continue turning under the maximum braking pressure. Disadvantages, it stops stop times. Anti-lock brakes are made to provide for surer braking in slippery conditions. However, some drivers report that they find the stopping distances for regular conditions are lengthened by their ABS system, either because there may be error in the system or because noise of the ABS may contribute to the driver not braking at the same rate. Okay, delicate system, it's easy to cause a problem in ABS system by messing around with the brakes. Problems include disorientation of the ABS system where the compensating brake sensor causes the vehicle to shudder, make loud noise, or generally brake worse. Cost. An ABS can be expensive to maintain. Expensive sensors on each wheel can cost hundreds of dollars or rupees to fix it, they get out of calibration, or develop other problems. System damage, a variety of factors can cause the system to be less effective and can present with everything from the shuddering or the vehicle to be loud noises while trying stopping. Some problems are there. That is, two more sensors are added to help wheel angle sensors and gyroscopic sensors. These are also required. This is about the anti-lock braking system. So today we finished this topic, ABS system, or it is also called an anti-lock braking system. So thank you.